All right, so long axis traction. You know, when people come in, you're trying to figure out, do they have back pain? Is it an extra-articular problem? Is it an intra-articular problem? And if they have an OA, and you'll do, can you guys see that okay? You can make that go at any level. You can go, you know, start in more flexion if you want to be a little bit looser, a little bit more comfortable. Chase them down to extension. But when you're in that evaluation and you pull on their leg, how many people in this room have heard that in their career where you pull and they're like, oh gosh, keep doing that. Please keep doing that. Like, don't, that's the best. My husband's too lazy, he won't do it. And my wife, you know, she won't do it. And so then they intuitively know that they want distraction. They want that pulled on. We know long axis traction, not curing cancer here, right? It's not going to fix anything. But when someone comes in really acute and a lot of pain and you can't touch them and they don't have a steroid injection, that's that one thing that you usually can do, especially if it's OA or FAI. Now, if it's that 19-year-old with hypermobile ballet dancer who has a labral tear, she or he may like some traction, but they don't want heavy traction. They're not gonna like that like somebody with moderate OA. They just wanna be unloaded. So they do well with a super band just to kind of unload them a little bit after training or after a long day at the office or whatever. But someone with OA, the super band is just not gonna be enough. It feels good, you can take it on the road with you, and it's a great tool, but it's just not gonna be enough, which we'll get to HipTrac here in a moment. But that long axis traction, besides kind of unlocking that pain, it's gonna cause relaxation. It's gonna create glute medius and glute minimus relaxation. It's gonna decrease hypertonicity of psoas. You're gonna see this neurophysiological relaxation that occurs, and it happens anywhere in the body. If we took everybody in this room and they said, how many have neck pain? And let's say 20 of you said they don't have neck pain. And I laid you down up here and we did a little soft tissue work. I did some traction and I said, how are you feeling? You're like, oh my gosh, I didn't realize how much pain I was in. There's a natural phenomenon, even if you don't have hip problems. So there's PGA Tour golfers, there's athletes on the ATP, the tennis tour, that get long axis traction and they don't have any pathology at all. They just want to recover from really intense training. And the athletic trainers do that. When I played basketball at Oregon State, I'm 22 years old and they're doing some of these osteopathic things to me and I'm like, I don't really know why they're doing it, but it feels good. So it's not just for people with disease either. All right, and then HipTrac. So HipTrac is a device here that basically replicates what we do in the clinic. You can do it on your bed, you can do it on the floor. It can replicate any degree of extension, abduction, IRER, and up to 30 degrees of flexion. And so most people, when they have hip OA or a capsular pattern, they lose their they lose favors, they lose IR, extension, abduction, they can't adduct, flex, centrally rotate, they lose all this stuff. And you gotta get them moving again. And so you start in that kind of loose pack position maybe, and the goal is to chase them into closed pack, right? That's the goal of any mobilization, right? Is try to get them in the closed pack. And people say, well, you don't mobilize a closed pack. And you're like, you're right. If I can get the close back, there's no need to mobilize. I already won, so we're done. But if you're always mobilizing a loose pack position, you're not chasing that restriction. And so, just like anywhere else. But in the beginning, on that first and second visit, you'd like to see them for a third visit. So you want to be boring a little bit, kind of get them used to grabbing them and pushing on their ankle skin or their hip or whatever. And you're sort of kind of trying to charm them a little bit. But then you got to kind of get into it. You got to ramp it up a little bit. So you got to kind of chase that close pack. The important thing here is the 400 to 1,000 newtons. So we know that in the literature that 400 newtons, give or take a couple 50 newtons, is what it takes to distract the human hip. But then we have studies that show that you get close to 800 newtons and it's even better for outcomes for mobility and pain. But again, we need a lot more research around this. But that's important here based on the newtons because this will produce up past that 800 to 1,000 newtons. The superband will not. So Superman's great. When you don't have this, traveling, hypermobile, or not that stiff. But if you got a stiff hip, you want this thing.